Hi everybody and welcome to beautiful Kefalonia. We are here in our last hour of our trip. We're about to go home. We've been here for a week. If you've been following me on Instagram, you will have seen all the spamming I've been doing on there. But we've been asked quite a few times, haven't we, to do a update video. Because, you know, with the current situation, the pandemic and all our cancelled trips to Vegas, people have been asking us to do an update video to let you know what we've been up to during the pandemic. So, Matthew, what have you been up to?
Well, like, lots of backyards. Not a lot of... Because the pitches are closed and the parks are closed.
Yeah, and school.
Well, Matthew's done really well. I was really proud of him. He's, the last 5 months, he hasn't complained, hasn't said a negative thing. He's just gone along with everything. Like a lot of other kids, he's just got on with it and adapted to it better than most of us, really. But this little holiday is like a, not just a treat for him, but a treat for us, but a treat for him as well, for being such a good lad over the last 5 months. And boy, did we need it.
Yeah, we did. Because, I mean, if you've been watching the videos for a long time, you'll know we've spoken about where we live. We live in a really small village in Scotland. There's not a lot there.
No.
And, I mean, we didn't even have, like, Uber or Uber Eats. So when we were in lockdown, We didn't leave the house, right?
Yeah.
Like, Matthew and John left the house to take the dog for a walk locally. And that was it. So we were inside and it rains a lot where we live. So we were just pretty much inside for 4 months.
Yeah.
So we just needed to get away.
Yeah.
And initially we booked Lanzarote. We'd never been, but we booked Lanzarote. And then 4 days after we booked, the UK government put it on the quarantine list. So we had to choose somewhere where we could go really quickly. And so a week before we came, we chose Greece. We've never been to Greece. Well, Matthew and I have not been to Greece. No. John's been a long 20, time ago.
25 years ago since I went to Greece. So.
And we would never have chosen to come here, right?
No. Yeah.
It's never been on our list to come and visit. We're just, you know, we're in our lanes when it comes to holidays. We go where we like to go.
But and there, of course, there are different places in Greece.
Yes.
You don't just come to Greece. There's hundreds and hundreds of different islands, of
yeah.
course.
So many different.
And we chose Kefalonia because it's got a good reputation and it's different. It's lovely, isn't it? It's nice and green and
lots of mountain
original
areas and obviously the beach, which we love. But we've been really pleasantly surprised.
Yeah.
We've loved it here. We've had an amazing time. Obviously, a lot of it has to do with being locked in for 4 months.
Yeah.
But I think we came with no expectation.
I've been not mildly surprised, but I've enjoyed it more than I thought I would. And
birds flying high. Sun in the sky, sun in the sky. You know how I feel. Birds flying high.
The foods, we found a couple of really nice little restaurants that are off the beaten track slightly, and they were really nice. Beaches.
Yeah.
We had a drive around the island, which is really, really worthwhile.
Yeah.
So much to offer for such a small island.
Yeah.
Historically and the geography, the mountains, the beaches. It's such a lovely little place.
I know there was a couple of you on Instagram who said that you're planning on coming. So, yeah, if you've not been here before, highly recommend it. I think we definitely would like to return next year.
Oh, we'll definitely come back. If not next year, depending on how things go, in a couple of years' time. so easy for us to pop on at Glasgow and, you know, half an hour to the airport and we're here.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, it's definitely worth it.
So, as far as what John and I have been doing during the lockdown, I've been working from home since about the 17th of March.
Yeah.
My office is only 5 minutes drive from where we live, so I've popped in a couple of times since lockdown was lifted.
And I've been working
normally. He has a really good schedule, so he works 2 weeks on, 3 weeks off.
Yeah.
So he's been doing his regular 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So that's what we've been doing, just like everybody else around the world. We've just been trying to
get around it,
just trying to get on with it. We've been doing what we've been told.
Yeah. Strictly doing
following, what we've been told. Following the rules. Yeah. And as far as travel is concerned, obviously, like most of you guys, we've had quite a few trips cancelled this year. After I came back in February, I booked May straight away. So I was due to go back to Vegas in May and had to cancel that. John's skiing trip March was cancelled a couple of days before Norway went into lockdown. We've had July's Vegas and Bahamas trip cancelled, which
is disappointing. We changed that to August, didn't we?
And then we changed that to August, hoping that we could do that. So we cancelled August as well, and then we've come here. We have got a
Christmas trip booked.
A Christmas trip. So this is a trip announcement as well. Wow. Yeah. So yes, we have a trip to Vegas booked for Christmas and New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
Obviously, we don't know if that's going to happen, fingers crossed.
Yeah.
Because we really loved spending Christmas there, but we don't know what's going to happen.
But if that doesn't happen, we're going to come here for a week.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
we'll use that.
As soon as we can travel back to Vegas. Yeah. I know you guys are wanting the Vegas vlog to vlogs. We'll be back as soon as we can,
and we want to go back.
Yeah, we want to go back. Yeah. We would like to go and support the Vegas economy. We love it. So.
Just one thing about the travel, and the people have been slightly nervous about traveling with face masks and the airport and stuff like that. Don't be. It is so easy, and it's not really a drama. It's a means to an end, and if you're, I guess a 9-10 hour transatlantic flight with a mask on might be a problem, but not really.
With the airport as well, it's a long time.
If you use a really good breathable paper mask and have a couple of spares rather than a reusable one, they're easier to breathe through. You can breathe through the sides easy enough. It's not really a drama. The airports are nice and clear and empty. In some ways, it's easier than travelling as normal because the airports aren't packed.
Yeah.
You board easier, you exit the plane easier, there's more room on the aircraft, there's less people travelling. It's actually quite a nice experience apart from wearing a mask for a bit, but that's not a problem really, are they? We didn't find it a problem, did we, Matthew? No, not a problem at all.
And I was apprehensive about travelling with a mask. I was really scared. I thought, how am I going to do this? I can't even cope. I've been to the grocery store like three times since March. I've just not been going out. And I was really worried about coping with the mask. I was worried about you coping with a mask in the airport.
It's been easy.
But we've actually found it very easy. We all have the cloth face mask, but we actually found the disposable ones much easier to travel with.
And as for the hygiene and in Greece, everybody just gets on with it and does what they're meant to do. From teenage children, they socially distance, they wash their hands, they don't gather in large groups. All the shopkeepers are wearing masks and disinfecting everything all the time. All the restrooms, bathrooms are absolutely immaculate. You can tell they clean everything all the time. Even the car rental guy yesterday, you know, wouldn't come anywhere near me, stayed away, had a wipe, wouldn't get in the car after me.
They
asked
fog the machine.
You know, they fog the cars. Yeah. He asked me for the mileage, he asked me for the petrol, he didn't even sit inside the car. So, you know, they're all doing it properly, and that's probably one of the reasons their infection rates here are so low.
Yeah.
They're just getting on with it. So it's a lovely place to be.
So if you're concerned,
don't be concerned.
I mean, everybody's different in their opinions of the virus and the pandemic, but I think our Team Claire opinion is travel. We don't know what's going to happen with travel. Nobody knows. We don't know when we can travel to America. We don't know, the virus could just disappear. It could not. But we need to learn to live with it. And for us, we will travel as as we can. We'll take the opportunities when we can, as long as you're sensible. You know, we're just not going to stay indoors for the rest of our lives until there's a vaccine. So, and coming years open my eyes that you can do it.
Provided you're, you know, provided you're doing what you're told, you know, your personal hygiene levels are right, you don't mix with people you don't know. You wash your hands, you stay away from people, it's fine.
It's good.
Which is fine
too,
for us, because we do that anyway.
And it's good because actually it's great that people stay away from us. You know, you get your personal space in the airport. But yeah, that's it, guys. We have to go because we're going to get picked up pretty soon to take to go back to the airport, and it's a 2-hour coach ride back to the airport. But that's the update. We're fine, we're here, we're alive, and we're well, and we hope to see you soon again from Vegas. Thank you for all the support on Instagram and Twitter, and also still on the channel, and we'll see you guys soon.
Hopefully. Bye. Sun in the sky, sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Birds flying high.